precious than, by Google's definition, the capacity of an agent to act in accordance with objective morality rather than under the influence of desires. Having a sense of ownership and responsibility for ourselves and the world we live in is priceless. We need to press into curiosity and lean into our God, divine, ancestral, given intuition. Unapologetically embracing our inherent goodness, not wretchedness like so many of us were taught to believe, and wholeness and mind, body, and soul. Knowing that liberation doesn't just free individuals, but to all the world around us. I want to live in a world where kindness and inclusivity extend beyond the heart and into action, where we embody the power that we each possess. So I will be real, I don't do much Bible reading these days, but my favorite verse is still 2 Timothy 1:7. Says, for God did not give us a spirit of fear, but a spirit of power, love, and self-discipline, which I interpret as self-intuition and responsibility of self. That translation, by the way, is by me. We can't live in fear, but we gotta live out our power and love and take responsibility with our actions. I think one of the ways that we can incorporate and embrace that power is to know our worth. For example, the industry and society has taught me to find my best angles, which in turn caused me to find my worst angles. Photographers would ask in photo shoots, they would say, well, which is your best side? And naively, I thought they were talking about like which hand was more dominant, and so I'd say my right. And for a long time, I honestly didn't even know which side was my best angle. So I stared at myself, I picked myself apart, I looked for what it seemed like other people liked, what kind of pictures did people like more. And as I age, I look for, you know, which side looks younger or more proportionate. And I'll be honest with you guys, I really don't see that kind of stuff. At least not right away. And sometimes ever. Because details are really not my specialty. You can ask Adam, my husband, you can ask him. I'm not your gal when it comes to like helping you decide if the bookshelf is level or if the painting is hung straight. I don't see those sort of things. So staring at myself to try to find like the angles or the vibes or pictures that people like the most was just really unnatural for me. One of my favorite parts of summer is the fact that you don't have to wear that much clothes. I know I'm wearing a hoodie right now, but for the most part, I like to keep our AC low and we end up not wearing a bunch of clothes. I like it for me, but I also like summer for like other people too. I've always loved bodies. I've always loved seeing people in the most raw forms. So like I genuinely like blemishes, stretch marks, cellulite, thin, thick, skinny, fat, wild hair, flatter hair, acne, wrinkles. Honestly, I love it all. It's all beautiful. So being told to kind of pick myself apart wasn't natural for me, and it was difficult. But like anything else, once you see something, you can't unsee it. And that sucks. I hate it. I genuinely love myself, but there are days that I don't as much as I wish that I did, just like everybody. So recently, I have been trying to take photos on my not best angle or side, because honestly, I love that side too. A second way of embracing our God, divine, given power is by setting boundaries. And I just wanna say, just because someone or something, a doctrine, a theology has been a part of your past, doesn't immediately grant them or it any of your future. We live in a very IOU mentality, whether we realize it or not. We're constantly handing out our energy as if it's not sacred. We're not creating boundaries as if that's not critical for our mental health. And if we're not careful, we may live as if we owe people or things our souls, allowing our gratefulness, i.e. our fear of them, to dictate our choices. Keeping ourselves locked within, not trusting ourselves or God within, not believing our own experiences, but instead looking to others to validate or approve of our existence. So we gotta be aware of to who we are being grateful for and why. If we're not careful, our own IOU mentality can keep us on this merry-go-round of unworthiness and unwholeness. The third way of embracing your power is to take up space. If nobody's ever told you this before, there is enough room for you. More than enough, you are worthy to be loved and to love. Your stories and experience matter. Speak your truth and chase the things that light you up. If the systems or relationships or the friendships that you have require your brokenness to function, you need to get out. You deserve a whole life. If most of your decisions are based off of what your community, whether that's religious, family, friendships, social media, etc. If your decisions are based on what they might think of you, or if they're based out of the fear that they will abandon you or you will be exiled, is that really the community that you need? Is that really the system in which you thrive or want? Take up space in this world. Life is so much better when you're living it. Speaking of taking up space, I did want to mention something that has happened. On July 3rd, Indigenous people and allies were arrested in the process of defending their sacred lands in the Black Hills. Acts of courage and civil disobedience resulted in arrests and criminal charges. They were protesting the desecration of the sacred lands of their people that was stolen from them. So if you celebrated the 4th in any way, please consider donating to their bail.
Hey guys, so I'm editing the video and I wanted to make note that the protesters have been released from jail, but now they're facing excessive charges, so the link still benefits them and the cause. I just wanna let you know that they are now out of jail and, but still need the support, so. Click the link.
Yeah, and considering the state of this country, my 4th wasn't so cheery. So on the 5th, I chose to rest. I chose rest as resistance. 2020 sort of has this way of shining a light on everyone and everything, doesn't it? I've received messages from folks that are just really upset and really, really don't like me challenging their version of America's history. It's ridiculous and hurtful. So I've taken advantage of the block button the past couple weeks, and that is a boundary I've set in place for myself. I digress. I do hope that you are finding peace and rest, but also ways that you feel powerful, embodying the power and the love that you are born with. And remember, you're worthy of taking up space. Be a kind human and live your truth. Bye guys.
That's so cold.
Cheers. Oh my cheers.
Cheers up for the popsicle. Here you go. Here's my popsicle.
Over and out.
I didn't know what you're trying to eat there for a second.
It's not getting me because I'm too short.
Dang it.